Well, it was the itsy bitsy teeny weeny bikini that changed Australia's beach fashion landscape forever. And tonight Australia is mourning the woman who brought it here. Pioneer Paula Stafford was known as much for her once controversial designs as she was for being an astute businesswoman and wonderful friend. Now we've lost our bikini queen, aged 102.
She was as gold as the coast itself, as glittery as the strip she called home. Bikini Queen Paula Stafford certainly was a bombshell.
I was flat out to find five girls for a fashion parade who would undress to a bikini.
The pioneer who brought the skimpy swimsuit to Australia has died just 13 days after turning 102.
I love G-scrims. Yes, I think they're a great idea.
After studying fashion in Victoria, she escaped the cold and moved to the Gold Coast in the 1940s. And after having three children, she decided to start making what she called two-piece swimwear. And boy, did that raise some eyebrows back in the 60s.
And of course, a beach inspector told her she wasn't quite appropriately dressed on that occasion. And that was the beginning of a wonderful career.
Debbie Miller first met Paula when she was just 16, and Paula turned her into a local modelling star.
She loved a wine, she loved a laugh, she had a great sense of humour, and she was just really jolly good fun to be with.
Paula Stafford is iconic on the Gold Coast. I haven't met anyone who doesn't love her. We got to celebrate her life. It's wonderful.
Yeah, I think she was part of many figures that put the Gold Coast on the map globally. Her legacy lives on through our industry.
But she was very serious when it came to business. Her granddaughter told us she was a PR machine. She led with her heart and was passionate. Her success wasn't an accident. It was born on the back of hard work. The great-grandmother revolutionised Australian fashion.
You know, everyone killed to own a Paula Stafford bikini.
Whatever waves Paula created here on Gold Coast beaches, she sure knew how to surf them. She knew how to create controversy and turn it into a positive. While the term icon may sometimes be overused, this time it's spot on.
Then my life would be a lot poorer if I hadn't met Paula, because I'd never met anybody else like her.
Amanda Hart for 10 News First.